I now call upon Mr. Rashmibhai Jhaveri to present his response to Dr. Zakir Naik. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Rashmibhai Jhaveri.
First of all, I really thank Dr. Zakir Naik for giving me the choice whether I would like to still remain a vegetarian or non-vegetarian. Thank you very much. I would request Mr. Coordinator that would you like to have the rebuttal or my comments now, or shall we have?
No.
Because after all, you know, this is...
No. Now it's better, you know, we'll...
Let's have some question part. Answer, if you think.
Question answer we have in the third session. We have three-part session. Yes, Mr. Jhaveri, you can continue.
Now, we are totally at the command of the coordinator, so I will obey.
As decided, you know, the same format we keep.
I will obey.
I will not allow Dr. Zakir also to change the format.
Now,
I'll object.
First thing that I will say, it's not a question of whether one is logical or illogical, and it's not a question of the choice that one makes. As I said in my talk earlier, everything is relative. And you have to understand this topic from that perspective. Now, one thing that I will very strongly object with respect to Dr. Zakir's, that not a single religion prohibits non-veg. I am expert, I can say, because I am a student. I have done MA in genealogy. I can say from my religious point of view that Lord Mahavir and our all 24 Tithankaras very vehemently prohibited non-veg food. I have already given you some quotations. You see, mainly arguments of Dr. Dean Ornish is based on the fact that non-veg food contains excessive protein, cholesterol, and saturated fat. So that is why he said that for healthy and peaceful living, you must have non-veg veg diet. Now, he said that plant has also got life. No, it is not only proved by Dr. Jagdish Chandra Bose, but even our Lord Mahavir, he stated 2,500 years ago that not only plant, air, water, fire, minerals of the earth, they all have life. He has not said that you are allowed to kill this life and maintain yourself. But he was a practical Tirthankara. So he said that those who cannot renounce this world and become Jain Muni, you know, Jain Munis, they don't even kill plant vegetation or even other living beings for their food. They bake the food which is cooked in our house. We'll not go into that controversy that even you kill it and then give them. That's a separate story. But the teachings of Mahavir are very clear that you shall not harm any living being, whether animate or inanimate. Now, because of certain constraint for those people who cannot renounce the world, he has said that at least you can avoid essential killing. He has said that even if you, when you have food made out of plant, it is violence, it is hinsa, but it is necessary. So what I prohibit is unnecessary killing. Friends, this is a very sharp distinction, but very important distinction we should make, that if the alternative is available, we should not go for that alternative which compels us to kill and eat our own fellow creatures. Another thing, so he said plants. In my talk I stated about plant food, and he said that even a lizard can grow tail. That's the only exception. The plants, you pluck fruits, they will give you more fruits. You cut their branches, more branches will grow. See, there is no end to such argument. So let us restrict our argument to this. About medical science, and he rightly stated that medically also he has given certain things, I have also stated. Now, it is for the enlightened audience to decide whether the scientific facts that I have given are correct or he has given. It's okay. It's a question of argument. Now, he has conveniently forgotten. Please excuse me, I'm telling because I'm trying to rebut your things. The psychological aspect. When we consume animal food, we also inherit certain animal instincts. What have you to say? Please, in your rebuttal, you can say that. Now, doctors also, most of the doctors prescribe raw vegetable. Now, coming to cooking, most of the doctors prescribe raw vegetables for healthy diet. Only that food or cereals which will not be proper for a human being to consume raw, that only can be cooked. But as far as possible, and in our Indian Vegetarian Congress, we always, whenever we have a meeting, we have most of the food raw, uncooked, and that is more healthy, according to us. About the books, these books were not given by me to Dr. Nayak, and it was given by my friend, Mr. Salecha, who approached me. That's okay, it's nothing very important. Now, I will tell you one thing, that you cannot alter the truth by just loud applause. Okay, if you are impressed by my argument, you may applaud me. Or if you are impressed by the other argument, you can applaud that. But I firmly believe that just because some arguments are appealing to you and you applaud them loudly will not alter the truth. And I have referred to about one book, Dr. Deepak Chopra. He has also written many books. He is also a physician, practicing physician, like Dr. Dean Ornish. He has also conducted researches. And he has come out with a theory that your food will have a terrific effect on your impulses and urges, your physical development, psychological development, and emotional development. You know, most of the psychological and emotional distortions are because of the flesh food that one eats, and that is why it is prohibited. It is totally illogical to say that by eating animals, you are helping vegetarians. We should not worry about the animal population because nature is quite capable of taking care. Why? Because we are rearing more animals for killing. That is why if we are not doing it, look at the jungle. Everywhere the natural cycle is there. Balancing will take care of itself. Nobody has to worry about it. Now, as per the history that Mr. Trivedi also referred and also Dr. Jakir, now I will tell from Jain historical point of view that in our Jain scriptures, it is mentioned very clearly that those persons who were living in prehistoric stage, they lived under a tree and they were sufficiently provided by trees, did not have to go for any killing. Friends, I am of course given more time, but I really personally feel that let's not have a sort of dialogue or arguments between. I would like very much the audience to participate and have more time for question and answer. Thank you.
Thank you, Zaveri. We have more. It's taking 5 minutes left. Now I call upon Dr. Zak to present a response to Mr. Rashmi Bhai Zaveri for 15 minutes only.
Alhamdulillah. Wassalam. Ala Rasulillah wa ala Ali wa sahbihi ajma'in. Amma ba'd. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Wa qul ja'a batil. إن الباطل كان زهوك من القرآن ما هو الشفاء ورحمة المؤمنين ظالمين الله خسارة بسم الله الرحمن رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي Respected people on the dais, elders and my brothers and sisters, welcome once again, all of you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi. May peace, mercy and blessing of Allah be on all of you. Conveniently forgotten anything. I spoke maybe half minute more. So how can